Good evening. Welcome to our service of worship at the Bethel Baptist Church. Welcome to those who are joining us online, and it's really wonderful to see everyone who is here this evening. We invite you now to stand, if you are able, as we share in the responsive call to worship. God our Father, today in remembrance and awe, we tread this holy ground of Calvary.
This place of abandonment that has become the scene of our adoration.
This place of suffering that has become the source of our peace.
This place of violence that has become our battlefield on which love is victorious.
Father, as we relive the events of this day, it is with awe that we count the cost of our salvation. Words cannot be found to utter our thanksgiving. Accept our silent adoration. In Jesus' name, amen. Our opening hymn, At the Dawning of Salvation. Please remain standing if you can. Please be seated. Again, a warm Bethel welcome to everyone online and in chapel, and a special welcome to those who are worshiping with us for the very first time. If you are here in chapel and this is your first worship experience at Bethel, we invite you to stand. And if you are online, we invite you to indicate on the website. Yes, we have one person there. Welcome, welcome. If you're online, please. Thank you, you may be seated. If you're online, please indicate on the website where it says I'm new or in the chat feature. Thank you so much for being here this evening and for choosing to spend this evening with us as we worship the Lord on this Resurrection Day. May I just invite us to, it's been a while since we've done this, to stand and sing together, There's a Sweet, Sweet Spirit in This Place. And then I'll take us through a few notices. So let's just stand and sing, There's a Sweet, Sweet Spirit in This Place.
There's
sweet, sweet spirit in this place. And I know it is the spirit of the Lord. There are sweet expressions on each face. And I know it is the presence of the Lord. Sweet Holy Spirit, sweet Heavenly Dove, stay right here with us, filling us with your love. Amen. You may be seated. Thank you. I'd just like to highlight a few of the notices, just to remind us that on Wednesday, we continue our Bible study at 7 p.m., the values of the kingdom, and you may join either in chapel or online as you are doing now. The funeral service for our sister Ina Aarons will be this Friday, April 22nd, or the 22nd of April, at 11 a.m. here at Bethel. We encourage you to please remember to continue praying for her family. We also pray for others among us who are bereaved. Our sister Sylvia Wright and family, Sister Kaylin Burnett and family, Sister Lloydine Ebanks and her family, and we pray too for the family of Sister Perlene Walters, who passed away recently, and the family of Reverend Edgar Henry, a retired minister of the Jamaica Baptist Union, who also passed away recently. So let's bear all these persons up in prayer as they mourn the loss of their loved ones. We continue also to pray for those among us who are ill, and we pray for our brother William Taylor, who continues to be hospitalized, and for brother Uton and sister Iona Williams, as they too are not well. So let us just continue to hold each other in our prayers as we ask the Lord for our Easter miracles. So welcome to this evening of Easter music. The past 2 years, we have missed many of our usual events, and this is one of those that, you know, we have had, that we have missed over the past couple of years, thanks to the pandemic. So it's wonderful to be here. It's great to be in the house of the Lord and to gather online as well with the people of God. So we are grateful to the music ministry for putting this program together, and we wait in anticipation for what is to come. Our first section will flow without interruption or without announcements. The music will be interspersed with readings, and we will have items from the adult choir, from Master Dwayne Porter, Mrs. Yannick Liba Ebanks, and the youth chorale. So let us just make ourselves comfortable as we worship the Lord with Easter music, listening to our brothers and sisters who have prepared a feast for us. Thank you again for being here, and let us move on into our first section.
We see crowded streets, for the city of Jerusalem is filled with excitement. A triumphant march is heard as Jesus majestically rides through the crowds. Listen, you will hear the people thronging the way singing, "Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord."
King.
4 days later, the mood has changed. The religious leaders have plotted to take Jesus' life. While in the Garden of Gethsemane, the soldiers arrest Jesus and take him before the Roman governor. The crowd lobbies for the release of Barabbas instead of Jesus. When asked, "What is to be done with Jesus?" the crowd shouts, "Crucify him!" Jesus is then led down the road to Calvary to be crucified.
Down the Via Dolorosa in Jerusalem that day, the soldiers tried to clear the narrow streets, but the crowd pressed in to see the man condemned to die on Calvary. From a beating, there were stripes upon his back, and he wore a crown of thorns upon his head, and he bore with every step the scorn of those who cried out for his death. Down the Via Dolorosa, all the way of suffering, triste día en Jerusalem. Los soldados le abrían paso a Jesús, mas la gente se secaba para ver al que llevaba aquella cruz. Por la vía dolorosa, que es la vía del dolor, como veja vino Cristo, Rey Señor, y fue Él quien quiso ir por su amor, por ti, por mí, por la vía dolorosa al Calvario. Down the Via Dolorosa.
Jesus came and saved me, took my sin to Calvary. He has made a way for me. And now my eyes are open, since I've come to know Him. His great love has set me free.
The crowd shouts, "Crucify him! Crucify him, King of the Jews, save yourself. He is not the Son of God. Where are your friends now? Save yourself. Jesus said not a word, but set his face like a flint to go up to Calvary. The healing hands of Jesus, God showed a lost world his plan for salvation. It was those same hands which were nailed to a cruel cross on Calvary. They beat him, they mocked him, they crowned him with thorns and led him away to die.
Thank you.
Thank you all very much for that first section. And I must apologize to Brother Dante Porter, who I think I announced as Dwayne Porter. The organ solo was done by Dante Porter. But thank you very much for all the music that we and readings that we have had thus far. We are now privileged to worship the Lord by giving our financial gifts. I invite the ushers to take their places as we prepare to give to the Lord. Let us pray. Generous God, you have held nothing back from us. You have given us your only begotten Son, whose death and resurrection give us salvation and life eternal. Everything we have comes from you, and all we are is yours. May we give of our best to you because you deserve our worship. Accept these gifts we present, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. We'll remain seated as we sing during the offering. Doxology. We now have our second section in which we will be blessed by music from Take Two, from our sister Mia McIntyre, from the youth chorale and the adult choir. And we will also have readings in between the various items. Please enjoy.
what shall we say to these things? There's still cancer and so much disease. What shall we say to these things? So much hurting and broken esteem. So many questions, but still one answer. It's getting hard to believe. And what shall we say to these things? So many people hurting with broken esteem. So many questions, but still one answer. If God be for pay nothing but the blood of Jesus.
After his crucifixion, Joseph of Arimathea, along with Nicodemus, wrapped the body of Jesus in a linen grave cloth and placed it in a new tomb. The soldiers guarded the tomb to ensure no one came to take the body. When Mary and Mary Magdalene went to the tomb early on Sunday morning, they could not find Jesus' body. The tomb was empty.
Oh,
The story of Jesus Christ does not end with his resurrection. He lives in our hearts, and we have been commissioned to share this truth with the world. So today, we crown him King. We praise and magnify his name. We worship his majesty.
Majesty, worship his majesty.
I am sure you will agree with me that we should be grateful to God for allowing us to be a part of this evening's wonderful Easter music feast. Let us. I am so happy that, you know, we could have had this wonderful production this evening to worship the Lord in this way and to share fellowship with each other. Thank you all so much for being here. And on your behalf, I thank all those who ministered to us in music, the adult choir, the youth chorale, and the Take Two, our sister Mia McIntyre, our brother Dante Porter, and our sister Yannique Liba Ebanks, and all their companies, Sister Joy Simons Brown, who played for us, Orane Shaw, and our brother Artie Lewis. Thank you all very much. We appreciate your ministry, the talents that you have given to the Lord, and the time and effort that you spend in preparing these feasts for us to enjoy. We're grateful also to those who provided administrative support in the planning and organizing of this event, and the technical team for the communications ministry. Thank you to our ushers also for their ministry to us this afternoon. And we thank Petals and Promises, our sister Margaret Anderson and her team, for their for the beautiful decor that we have been accustomed to having from them. Thank you all very much. And our sister Deacon Carlene Bisnott, you know, she's the one who led the way, planning this, pulling it together, getting the items in place, preparing the adult choir. And we thank all those Jordan masters who led the youth chorale, and all those who led and worked with Take Two as well. So thank you, everyone who played a part in making this evening possible. And for you for being here and for being online, sharing in this time. And so we are just about at the end of our evening of music. We have the finale, and we invite the groups to come back now for I Am, after which we will close with prayer and the benediction. You may remain in your places, and I invite you to stand if we are able, and let us pray. Now all glory to God, who is able to keep you from falling away and will bring you with great joy into his glorious presence without a single fault. All glory to him who alone is God, our Savior, through Jesus Christ our Lord. All glory, majesty, power, and authority are his before all time and in the present and beyond all time. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you all, now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Have a wonderful evening, everyone, and a great week. God bless you.